Hello students, welcome to class 5. So students, in our previous lecture, we have discussed classification of polymers based on synthesis. And we have seen that polymers on the basis of synthesis can be categorized into two important classes. That is, addition polymerization and condensation polymerization. So students, in our today's lecture, we are going to discuss stereochemistry of polymers along with mechanism of stereochemical control of polymerization using Ziegler-Natta catalyst, followed by natural and synthetic rubbers, additive to polymers and biodegradable polymers. So let's get started. Stereochemistry of polymers. In branched polymers, the side chain can have different arrangements with respect to the polymer chain. Due to difference in the special arrangements, the polymer shows stereoisomerism. Tacticity. It is defined as the difference in special order of side chains on the polymer chain, leading to stereoisomerism. Three types of stereoisomerisms are possible. One is isotactic. In this, all the side chains are arranged on the same side of the polymeric backbone. Second is syndiotactic. In this, the side chains are arranged alternatively on either side of the polymeric backbone. And third, atactic. In this, all the side chains are arranged randomly on either side of the polymeric backbone. In isotactic and syndiotactic polymers, chains can be packed together better because of regular arrangement of side chains, making the polymer more crystalline. So the polymer becomes stronger, rigid, and will have higher melting point. In atactic polymer, due to random arrangement of side chains, they cannot be packed closely. Therefore, it is more amorphous. Hence, it has lower melting point and it is a soft polymer. Next is mechanism of stereochemical control of polymerization using Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Ziegler-Natta catalyst was developed in the year 1953 for polymerizing alkene monomers. The active catalyst is thought to be an alkyl titanium compound formed by transfer of an ethyl group from aluminium compound to titanium chloride. So first, the alkene monomer coordinates with alkyl titanium compound to form D-pi complex and then inserts the titanium carbon bond to form a new carbon-carbon bond. Further, same steps are repeated, so we get the addition compound. Then finally, with the help of active hydrogen atom, which is obtained from alcoholic group, so it undergoes termination to get the formation of a polypropene. Reactions using this catalyst are known as coordination polymerization. Next is natural and synthetic rubbers. Natural rubber is a terpene which is composed of repeating isoprene units. The polymer is unsaturated, having Z configuration at all the double bonds, which makes rubber soft and elastic. Natural rubber is soft and finds less applications. In 1939, Charles Goodyear discovered that by mixing hot rubber with sulfur gave a stronger and more elastic material. This process is known as vulcanization. Vulcanized rubber is an elastomer and contains many cross-linked disulfide bonds which link the hydrocarbon chains. Next is diene polymerization, which includes 1,2 addition and 1,4 addition. When conjugated diene is polymerized, it gives unsaturated polymer. This is an addition polymerization. For example, 1,3-butadiene, when polymerized at very low temperature, 1,2 addition takes place and the other double bond will be in the side chain in the polymer. However, at moderate temperature, 1,4 addition takes place, in which both the double bonds are simultaneously involved. Next is cis and trans polymerization. In case of 1,4 addition polymerization, the product can have different stereochemistry, that is all cis or all trans configuration. If 1,3-butadiene is polymerized by free radical mechanism using a peroxide, then all trans configuration is formed. Whereas, if Ziegler-Natta catalyst is used for polymerization, then all cis configuration is formed. Next is synthetic rubbers, which includes three important categories. First is polyisoprene, second is chloroprene, and third is Buna-S rubber. First one, polyisoprene. When isoprene is polymerized under free radical condition, in presence of a peroxide, all trans polyisoprene is obtained. On polymerization, in presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, it gives all cis polyisoprene, which is termed as natural rubber. Second is chloroprene. Chloroprene gives trans or cis polymer by using peroxide or Ziegler-Natta catalyst, which is as shown as follows. Third is Buna-S rubber, which is obtained by copolymerization of styrene and butadiene in proportion of 1:3. This is called as a cold rubber, as it is prepared at lower temperatures. It is used in making tires and mechanical rubber goods. Next is additives to polymers. It includes three important categories. First is plasticizers, second is stabilizers, and third is fillers. So first one, plasticizers. They are low molecular weight organic liquids which are added to the polymer to increase the flexibility of the polymer. Plasticizers reduce the brittleness of the amorphous polymer and hence increases its utility. It can penetrate the matrix of the polymer, causing polar attractive forces between it and chain segment. Hence, mobility increases, therefore polymer becomes more flexible. Efficiency of plasticizers depends on solubility, polarity, and density. Even hard brittle polymers can be easily processed by addition of plasticizers. It can be dialkyl esters or aryl inorganic esters. Second is stabilizers. Stabilizers are substances added to the polymers to chemically stabilize the polymer and arrest its degradation. Because the polymers are not chemically stable and may change color and gradually decompose, and sometimes gases are evolved. For example, PVC. It's a colorless but gradually changes color and it is thermally unstable. At higher temperature, it evolves HCl, which accelerate the degradation of the polymer. Hence, a stabilizer is added to neutralize HCl and stop further degradation. Stabilizers may be organic or inorganic or organometallic compounds. Next is fillers. Fillers are inert substances which are added to the polymers and are mainly used to increase the bulk of the polymer, thereby reducing cost of the polymer. It also helps to improve the physical stability of the articles made from the polymer. It helps to reduce the cost of the commercial polymers. For example, asbestos powder, sawdust, gypsum, paper, fabrics, etc. are added as fillers which do not affect the polymers chemically. For example, bakelite mixed with asbestos and sawdust is used to mold electrical items, telephones, etc. Novelic resin mixed with sand is used as core binders in foundries. Next is biodegradable polymers. These are polymers which can be degraded by microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, or algae, which are naturally present in the environment. These polymers are broken into smaller parts by reactions catalyzed by enzymes produced by microorganisms. Polyhydroxyalkanoids, PHAs, are naturally occurring polymers produced by certain bacteria. They are polymer of hydroxycarboxylic acids such as 3-hydroxybutyric acid or 3-hydroxyvaleric acid. The two common PHAs are PHB and PHV, that is polyhydroxybutyrate and polyhydroxyvalerate. There can be a copolymer of 3-hydroxybutyric acid and 3-hydroxyvaleric acid, which is known as PHBV. Next is properties. They are thermoplastic and their properties depend on whether they are homopolymer or copolymer. PHAs are used in making molded goods, paper coatings, non-woven fabrics, films and adhesives. In medical field, they are used as sutures and in orthopedics. Next is biodegradable polyamides. This can also be prepared from amino acids. Example, when aspartic acid is polymerized, it gives polyaspartate. It is known as TPA, thermal polyaspartate, which is used as an alternative to polyacrylic acid for lining pumps and boilers of wastewater treatment facilities. Next is biomedical uses of polymers. Synthetic polymers have widespread use in everyday life and in different fields of technology. The type of synthetic polymers required for biomedical applications are as follows. Polymers that are biostable like polytetrafluoroethylene, polyesters, polyamides and polyurethane are used for medical purposes like blood pumps, heart valves, skeletal joints, kidney prosthesis, etc. Polymers which are bioerodible. These materials, they serve short-term purpose in the body. And once their purpose is served, they decompose to small molecules, which further can be excreted. The copolymer of glycolic acid and lactic acid is used by surgeons as sutures to hold the tissues together until they heal. For replacement of heart valves, silicone rubber is used. For aneurysm, polyester or polytetrafluoroethylene fabric is used. And for completely blocked artery porous, polytetrafluoroethylene is used. Synthetic polymers can be glued to tissues. For example, polyalpha cyanoacrylate can be used as artificial skin. Bone fractures are repaired by use of polyurethane, epoxy resin and vinyl resin. Silicone rubber rods are used as replacement for finger and wrist joints. Polymethyl methacrylate polymers have been used for hard contact lenses. Nowadays, flexible or soft contact lenses are used, which is made from lightly cross-linked and water-soluble polymers, which uses hydroxyethyl methacrylate, that is also called as HEMA system. For artificial kidney, rayon fibers, polycarbonates or cellulose acetate fibers can also be used. In case of artificial blood cells, certain polymers like an emulsion of polytetrafluoroethylene can be used along with glucose, salt and surfactant. As these are biodegradable, it can be easily removed from the system by excretion. So students, these were few of the biomedical applications of polymers. So students, in our today's lecture, we have discussed stereochemistry of polymers along with mechanism of stereochemical control of polymerization using ZNC. Then we have discussed natural and synthetic rubbers followed by additives to polymers and biodegradable polymers.